Erin is definitely getting itself into the history books. Just as unbelievable this hurricane is doing everybody. It's going from a tropical storm to a Cat 5 hurricane in a 24-hour period. That is just incredible. And it didn't even go over the warmest deep ocean heat. It's just unbelievable. Matter of fact, it is still strengthening. It is expected to go all the way up towards 167 miles per hour, 201 miles per hour wind gusts. Plus, with the other two waves right behind this, I'm going to show you the latest update with Major Hurricane Erin. Also, what is coming behind that? I'm showing this potentially some good news, everybody. But look at all of this thunderstorm growth in the eye. This storm is unbelievably strong and it is seriously intensifying. Look at this. Look at all those lightning strikes in that center. That is crazy right there. Look at that. That is a machine, literally. Now, the latest advisory, the 2 p.m. update is out, and you still have tropical storm watches for the far northern Leeward Islands. You're getting all them storms now. The worst part is the strongest this storm's going to be, it is going to slow down and hit its brakes as it's feeling that shear, and then it's going to broaden out really to about triple times, maybe even quadruple times the size it is right now. And this is going to be all the way into the Atlantic, stretching all them waves, showing a little bit closer towards the East Coast, all the way towards Bermuda, but it's still pulling a very sharp right turn. And unfortunately, it looks like it's getting worse and worse as far as maybe impacts or even in landfall for Bermuda. Still have it going all the way up to 165 officially, then down to 160. And by the time it reaches towards the East Coast and Bermuda in 5 days, it's going to be right shy of a major hurricane. The information on the rainfall is still the same. If you're in the island, still Puerto Rico, Greater Antilles, over here in this great section, this is where they have a lower confidence of what you're going to get, 1 to 2, maybe even a isolated 3 from banding. But you can see the measurements here, all the heavy rainfall is going to be in the ocean. You're still going to get 2 to 4, you still got to isolate up to 6, isolated up to 4. 12z runs are in, and you can see they're in great agreement, everyone. It's going to start slipping away, all that intensification. Remember the very first video, the stronger it gets, the faster it's going to turn. In 5 days, being way out here, where it could potentially be bringing a bad scenario towards Bermuda or very close. A lot of the models are agreeing that it still keep on intensifying all the way until later on tonight, or it may be even early tomorrow. Just keep on trucking. This is definitely going into the history books. Now, these up here, that shows it still intensifies while it's getting a little bit of shear. It has a lot of moisture pocket all about it, and it has a big cyclonic outflow, which is very good. It's going to combat the dust that is going into, but with the dust and with the shear, it is going to eventually slow down and it is going to weaken down towards that Cat 4 or a Cat 3. Now, it still, if it combats it and still grows in size and keeps going, it could stay towards that low end Cat 4, I do believe. Showing that by the time it goes by Wednesday into Thursday, makes a turn. Here comes that next tropical wave coming through, and it even has a 50 up to a 60% chance of something to form right here. Now, this is where we're going into a different weather pattern. Look where we're at. We're in the early 20s of August, but the latest information shows that wave could go further towards that westward push. Now, what we could see is if it gets underneath this trough of shear, from what I'm seeing from a cold blast coming through on the eastern side of the U.S., it could sneak underneath as a very weak wave and then get last minute formation, either in the Gulf or right here along the coast. If that trough passes by, it could pull it to the west. Let me show you what I'm talking about. So real quick, let's finish off with Erin looking like it's getting really close by the time we go through Wednesday night through Thursday morning. Very close to the shore right there. Matter of fact, you see even better if I go right along the coast. Very close to shore right there. Now that has been drifting westward towards that icon run dramatically and has been agreeing with it. And if it gets just a little bit more of a wobble, it's going to be a very big and broad system, everybody. Bringing the rip currents, bringing the tides. But look at this. It's getting very close. It's a little bit concerning. Don't want to seem as a fear monger. So let me show you the runs. You can see right here with the European, this is a 12Z. You can see with the icon, exact same location, exact same time. Also, you can see with the Euro AI, exact same location, just a nudge to the right. Now, the GFS is the only one that's taking it way up the road. Also, is taking this wave, strengthening it up to something that's going to be strong and going to the Gulf. It's this big, nasty hurricane. I have an issue with that. Okay, it's going to be about timing. This is about the 22nd and the 23rd. And when this storm system comes in, it's going to be coming in while we get this trough. We're going to get some storms, but we got cooler air coming through. Now, everybody knows that will put shear on this system. But let's go through Erin real quick. Now, so far, it's bringing Wednesday night, Thursday morning, 40 and 50 miles per hour wind gusts, maybe up to 60 on the far outer banks, but also bringing 40 and 50 miles per hour wind gusts all the way towards the northeast. Plus, with those very big waves, very strong riptides, you need to be careful. It's going to be a very dangerous couple of days around the Mid-Atlantic and the Northeast. That is bringing it more like 12-foot waves towards 15 and 20-foot waves all the way to the Outer Banks. So be aware, it is going to be very powerful, and it is going all the way towards Delaware, all the way towards Jersey and Long Island, bringing y'all chances for 6 to 10-foot waves with all that yellow as that pivots a little bit closer. It's gotten a little bit closer. So you can see right here with the Euro, and when you compare it with GFS, it's even taking a sharper turn, which was making a very bad case for Bermuda. So here we go. You know me, let's go into the data, everybody. So looking at your Arctic oscillation, you see you have some cooler air that's going to come through, potentially go away, potentially stick around for a second time. And you also can see that negative NAO. Now, if you remember what a negative NAO does from years of me showing you. Now, I know y'all remember this shot from Dacula Weather. When you have a negative NAO, you get that high pressure in the northern Atlantic. This is going to move in right behind Erin, and it's going to block and put that colder air into the central and the eastern U.S. Now, remember, when this comes down, it will be a lowering jet stream, so it will bring severe weather as it's lowering down and bringing the cooler temps. At the same time, it's going to bring shear on anything that comes towards the U.S. And you can see that from here. So you look at your PNA, your Pacific North American pattern. We're about to go into a positive pattern. And once again, when you have a positive PNA, you got the high pressure on the West Coast. You got those hot temperatures still going on for y'all over there while we get that cool blast and that trough coming along the central and the east coast. So once this passes, you're going to get this heat building along the western U.S. This is in your troposphere. And then you have that cool down coming through with that trough. Now it's going to be close because this is going to be at the same time. You need to see this. So as this trough is coming down, shearing winds over and deeper, here is your tropical wave trying to travel on this run into the west. So this is where it runs into that issue. It gets sheared and gets pushed and just gets demolished while you get this cool front coming through. Potentially two of them happening back to back, which would be good because we have multiple waves coming through. At the same time, when Erin pulls away, we get that negative NAO. We get that high pressure in the northern Atlantic. We get that trough of cooled air coming through. That same high pressure is going to stretch out amongst the Azores, and this is going to help swing storms in, but mostly swing them around into the Atlantic. There's a chance for it to go into the Caribbean. It's a bigger chance for it to go into the Atlantic when you're on an Azores high versus a Bermuda high. So here we are by Thursday dealing with Erin over here. You can see the tropical wave that is trying to come into the Caribbean. You have another one right behind it. You have another one about to come off the coast of Africa. Remember, they're every 3 days, everybody. Showing that as it goes through, it starts moving away with Erin. You get that high pressure ridge. You get that high pressure ridge moving through while you get that trough moving through over here. And then it starts shearing away what's left of that storm as the high pressure swings it into the Atlantic because we're going to an Azores high. And on this run, demolishes it where it's not even a big deal, nothing to even fuss about. And so does the other ones, just no big deal. Potentially another big trough of cooler air coming on through. This is going to be a nice cold blast, but this is what protects the U.S. Now, we'll keep monitoring, of course, but the data shows me that we're probably going to be okay, but those can be some tricky turns. If it can get underneath that trough, it can head to the north after that, so we do need to watch it. The icon has it literally in 6 days, coming right into the Caribbean, showing it has issues already, but we are getting some rotation in the atmosphere. You see GFS, it takes it stronger, and it takes it in 5 days, and in 6 days, reaching right there at the same point. But in 6 days, Icon and Euro has Erin right here. GFS is already gone with Erin. So it's kind of a different weather pattern as that comes through, and showing that trough that's coming through might not be that deep, and we have an expanding high pressure in the Bermuda instead of the Azores, and is bringing that all the way to the west. So we still got to see what that high pressure is going to do, if it's going to go towards Bermuda or if it's going to go way far to Azores high. If it's a Bermuda high, then we need to look towards what GFS is saying. If it does go back, getting confirmed as going to be an Azores high instead, then this right here would not happen. This right here would not be true at all. You can see this with the Euro in 5 days, seeing that weaker wave. You're seeing that Azores high go back. The wave goes into the Atlantic, and then it gets sheared by that trough coming through from that cold front from that P&A. And just demolishing that wave and any wave behind it. Still showing it has that little bit of that possibility if it can form late, maybe get the timing a little different. Other than that, we have a lot of sinking air for the rest of August, everybody. But still showing as we go through September, it is going to be a powerful hurricane season backloaded, and it's going to get stronger and stronger. But that is the latest update, everybody. I'm not even going to talk about this over here. Y'all know what that is. I showed it the other day, the Panthers blocker. Put a little bit of shear. So thank you so much for your time, everybody. Hope you have a very great day. I will stay on top of the next weather pattern, make sure we are in a good agreement of what could happen and what cannot happen, now that you know what kind of atmosphere change we're going into. If you appreciate the latest update, make sure you hit that like button. Better share this information to another platform. Let other people see this data, everybody. This is very important, knowing that this trough is coming through. That's a great chance to shear anything coming towards us. That's a big chance. And remember, everybody, before I go, no matter what happens, all glory goes to God. 1 Corinthians 10:31-33. And this is by the Apostle Paul, everybody. Whether therefore ye eat or drink, or whatsoever ye do, do all to the glory of God. Give none offense, neither to the Jews, nor to the Gentiles, nor to the church of God, even as I please all men in all things, not seeking mine own profit, but the profit of many, that they may be saved. Amen. Remember, all glory does go to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. I hope you have a great rest of your day, everybody. I'll see you in the morning.